Welcome to Cupids.
All right, we're in Cupids, so let's go for a little ride through, see what this place is like. I've been here before, but it's a long time ago. It could be a little boring ride for the first portion because I think we're actually about 3 kilometers away from the scenic area. If I remember right, I was here about 2 years ago and boiled up a coffee down by these boats. It was like a little waterway that was kind of inside a bit further. I don't know how to explain that really. I'll show you in a minute. Another bike. Haven't seen too many today. I think that's maybe my third. I think Buddy actually got a little bit airborne that time. Or that, or his shocks are pretty bouncy because he popped up quite a bit. Now while I'm here, I'm debating on boiling up a coffee, but I'm also torn between looking for a little local coffee shop maybe and grab a coffee there, perhaps some pastry or something just to help out with breakfast, because all I have is a protein bar. That's not really holding me over so much right now. Yeah, so far, Cupids is just like a typical community. I know one thing, crossing Roach's Line was a little rough. There's no holes in the road. That's a good thing. It's just rough, the way it's patched up and stuff. Few cracks in areas, but I never notice either hole, which is a good thing. So in case you're considering crossing Roach's Line, there, you got my thumbs up, it's good. Oh, they got all these veterans. Oh, there's the memorial, which I stopped there one time. If you look, they got all the veterans on the poles there. That's a nice touch. Yes, that's where I had my coffee last time, and that's probably where I'll end up going at some point for a little stop. But we got to do our traditional drive-through. I'm here to show you Cupids, so I got to show you Cupids. Love these little red, rustic-looking. Look at that view. I posed next to that cannon last year, or the year before. And the wind is not too bad, so I will put up my drone. Lots of nice little areas to stop and sit and enjoy the views, though. There's plenty of little parking areas with picnic tables around. If I remember seeing on Google Maps, this road leads to Shark Cove. I'll just go up here a little further and turn around. Another bench. See if my memory is correct. There should be like a little tiny red shack up on the left up here somewhere. That's, the roof is fairly flush with the side of the road. For some reason that's ringing a bell. God, we got a beautiful province, don't we? Never even thought about looking for whales while I was here. It's probably too cold for whales. Yes, I stopped in there and sat on that bench. Maybe I was wrong about that little shack. Let's see what's down this way. You got nowhere to be. Beautiful spot to live, wouldn't it? I'm thinking out here, Shark's Cove. Another place you can sit and enjoy the view. Oh look, I see that building I was talking about, so I wasn't totally out to lunch. There it is right there. I knew it. Because I stopped and took my picture next to it. Whales. I feel like that's all I'll be doing for the next few weeks is looking for whales. By the air, how chilly it is, probably looking for icebergs soon. Well, I think I'm going to turn around right here because I don't know if this loops around. Actually, no, I'm not going to do that one. This will take me back. It's just a guess. Enter at own risk. Oh, guess not. Sorry, thought this was a road. Well, at least I found a place to turn around. And a view always looks different on the way back. So I'll let this keep recording. Plus, you have a fast forward button on your remote or on your phone, I'm sure. You can skip ahead. But see what I mean? The view is different going back. Beautiful, beautiful. And this is why I called myself the Meandering Newfoundlander. I know it's a weird YouTube name, weird nickname or whatever, but I was trying to be creative and I thought about, okay, what do I usually do? I usually just wander around aimlessly, just exploring, seeing what's down this road or that road. And that's basically the definition of meandering, just wandering aimlessly for the most part. So I decided to go with Meandering Newfoundlander. There, a little bit of trivia for you. Some UFI. Gotta love the bay. Nothing wrong with it. I love the fact that a lot of communities are starting to be more open to quads being able to be used on the roads. I mean, why not? Especially around these communities. Yeah, St. John's might be different, but I wonder what's up on the top of that hill. Some kind of structure up there. I might have to Google that later. On Roach's Land, I did notice the statue of a horse up on a hill. I was tempted to stop and get a drone clip of it, but I stayed focused. I said, today it's all about Cupids. Last time I was here, I was out on that wharf as well, just popped out. There was this fancy looking boat there. I don't know how to explain it really. But if you go through some of my old videos, it might be there. I don't know if I made videos back then or if I just took pictures. Maybe if I got close enough, I could fly my drone up and see what that is. I'm going to finish doing the loop over towards where those buildings are across the way before I park my bike somewhere. But unless I find a coffee shop, there's a pretty good chance I'll be going in that way. Actually, there's no question about it. Way Road. is there? Oh, there it is, a hiking trail there. Welcome to Spectacle Head Trail. Private property. I guess I'm not supposed to be over this way. I'm gonna do a loop, I think. Yeah, I don't need to be over this way. Could have done it. Nope, not quite. I'm gonna go back where the entrance is to that trail and just stop for a minute. Of course, there would be someone right next to it with a sign. Break this thing out. See if I can get it all the way up there and back in one piece. We shall see. I got three batteries. I'll use one for this and the other two for my coffee. I get a feeling this is a bad idea. It's only got 3/4 of battery life on it. Whoa, she's flying backwards for some reason. That's weird. I always do a few warm-up movements with it before I send it off. That way I can feel comfortable that it's safe. Must be the wind. But it's showing an obstacle. All right, I got 25 minutes of battery life. I don't think it's gonna work. But worst case scenario, I will have some clips of this area. See, the battery's life is dropping very fast. It's down to like 12 minutes already. Because I'm flying into the wind. So I'm probably not going to make it up there. Made it. All right, let's finish this little tour. I'm sure there are coffee shops around here somewhere, especially these tourist traps, these tourist attractions, like these kinds of places. But I think I'm going to stick with the outdoors and have my coffee outside. The process gives me a chance to unwind. Crow. It is freezing here this morning, or this afternoon. Not freezing, but it's a +8, which feels freezing. Stop here for a second. On a warmer day with less wind, this would be a nice spot to sit and hang out. Population 775. Still too many people. Get a picture. A bit wider. There we go. All right, I'm going to head over that way. Need a coffee to warm up, though this cold air shrunk my bladder. All right, let's continue on. Last time I was here, there was a Coast Guard boat. Picnic tables around this time. Do I want a picnic table or not? I'm so indecisive. So I don't like that bench because it's next to that electrical crap. maybe I'll just ride up there. What's the worst that can happen? Yeah, I think this is good enough. Gotta check out the boats no matter where you go. Enter at own risk. I bet on a nice day, especially fairly soon, this will be a busy spot. It is freezing. I think I might actually check Google Maps to see if there is a coffee shop. That way, I can go warm up for a few minutes before I hit the road again. Well, Northside Cafe looks like an option. Gotta do a stroll on the beach first, despite freezing to death. I should have picked a warmer day. Alright, I'm gonna get one more shot of drone clips before I go. Just of this area. Because it looks nice and I think it would look nice through the air. So, stick around to watch that part right now. Alright, that's enough flying for today. It is a bit windy and the drone is struggling quite a bit with some of the gusts, so I had to take it down. It's killing the battery so fast, can't really go anywhere with it anyway. So I'm gonna hop on the bike and try to find somewhere to have a coffee and warm up a bit. I suppose I could just go straight home, but nah, I'd like to have a coffee first. Well, I was talking to a gentleman that time, and it turns out that coffee shop that I was looking at is actually in Brigus, which is only about 2 kilometers away. I didn't realize it was that close. So, looks like I'm going to Brigus. Maybe. Worse things to be doing than driving around on a motorcycle looking for a coffee shop. So we're only 6 minutes away. Well, I hope you enjoy Cupids. I could easily end the video here and be done. My mission would be accomplished. All I wanted to do is show you around this beautiful spot. Right here. Yep. This must be like a shortcut. God only knows where Google Maps is taking me now, but temperature dropped to 6. Well, we made it to Brigus in one piece. I wonder, is this cafe shop the place I was at before where I had one of the best tea biscuits ever? I say one of the best because my mom makes the best tea buns. And I'm serious because she used to own a bakery, so she's a professional baker. It was only 2 weeks ago, I think it was, or a week ago, I was down here. Busier today though, I'm sure, now that the May 2-4 started. All I can say is thank God for Google Maps, because I'd get so turned around so fast. My sense of direction's horrible. Northside Cafe, right there. So this is where I'll be stopping. Staff between signs, the quay. Public parking. I can squeeze in back there. That's the joys of a motorcycle. Yeah, backing in here is taking longer than the ride here. Well, that was painful. Usually I can park a lot better than that. All right, coffee time.
I think I should be good. Actually, I can fold my mirrors in. One less thing to worry about. That way.
The last time I was here was, must be at least a couple of years ago, other than that ride I did last week. But I was here with my wife and we met up with another couple nurses and had coffee. It was nice.
Cottage Antiques.
Well, it looks like I won't be having coffee here today because this is for sale. That sucks. I was looking forward to a coffee. Came here for that. Well, that's just my luck, right? First time I decide I'm going to go to a public place for coffee instead of boiling up my own, it's closed. What are the chances? Now, how bad do I want a coffee? Because I'm not going to be riding around all afternoon looking for coffee. Alright, that was a fail. I'm starting to see the reason I don't like tourist season. It's not even started yet. Everything's too busy already. So you get a 2-for-1 today. You get Cupids. And you get to see a little bit of Brigus. I think I found a spot for coffee. Since it's not busy, I should be okay to park here.
First thing is first. I need to get my toque. If not, I'm gonna freeze to death. It is freezing here, like everywhere. It's easier to do with two hands. There, I'm good. I had to get my gear. I think I'll go to this end where the sun is still hanging out. Looks all right, hey? Still a bit of a breeze, but I imagine this is a popular spot in the summertime. Has to be. It's a little swimming area to get the ladders everywhere. It's nice. This cold definitely shrinks the bladder, that's for sure. It is like uncomfortably cold today. I know, I've been whining about it, and I usually enjoy the cold, or at least the cool. Once we get the coffee going, I'll give you a little tour of this beach. We'll take a stroll around. If I ever get it going. Because my teeth are going to be chattering here soon. Switch to this side, get the sun in my face a bit. And she's ready by the looks of it. Good timing. And of course, I gotta do the taste test. It's good and hot, and it's not too hot today because I'm trembling here. Like, that's how cold I am. I didn't dress for this today. I got this mesh type of material in my jacket. I have the rain liner and a little thin fleece shirt on. It's not warm enough for 6 degree temperatures. Thank God for coffee. and heated seats and grips, because that definitely helps. First thing I'll show you is the ocean. Prioritize, right? And no, there's no whales. Sorry. I'm not sure if that's private property or not. I can't see it. No, definitely not. Because it connects all the way up there to that parking area. It's a nice little boardwalk. Look, I could have had my coffee over there instead of here. Nice view. A little bit of a breeze. Had to fix my crooked hat. I noticed that the logo was over on the side of my head. Yeah, I should have wore winter clothing. Too bad it's so windy. I'd get my drone up in this area as well. But on the plus side, I saved or killed two birds in one stone, because I had planned on stopping here for a coffee at some point, so I got to do it today. That's efficiency, I think, is what you'd call that. I can imagine there's some days when the surf comes in and just splashes right over this wall of rocks. I'd say it'd be a cool sight to watch. But I gotta say one thing, it's some warm down here compared to up there, because this wall of rocks is actually blocking all the wind. So it's a wind for me. Sorry, enough of the dad jokes. You can see over here, they're actually splashing up a bit. You see the rocks are all damp. Come on, waves. There we go. We'll stay here until we get splashed. No, no more splashes. Of course, the splashes are always where you're not looking. Because to my left, there's been a couple good ones. Oh, there we go. It's a little one, but it counts, right? All right, let's move on. Oh, I got the wind to my back and the sun in my face and a coffee in my belly. That's comfort. Something like that. I imagine in July, when we get that 1 week of summer, that this is just booming. It's a nice little setup though. It's perfect. Play a little beach volleyball. Again, this is one of those places where you see it from the road when you're passing by numerous times, but you never actually take a pause or take a moment to actually stop and have a look. Sorry, I know this is not Cupids. But it might give you ideas on places you can go and stop and take a breather and clear your head. definitely no worries about this today. This beats stopping in a coffee shop. I'm not as warm as that I would be in a coffee shop, but this whole experience beats it. I'm not surrounded by crowds of chattering people, the clinging and clanging of pots and pans in the kitchen. Yeah, those are all the things that get to me. That's why when I go out to restaurants, which I don't do very often, but for example, if I go to Winging It, I always strategically pick a spot that's away from the high activity level or areas, just because it sends me into a frenzy. Like, I get really frantic and I just need to escape. It's kind of that kind of a feeling. I don't get that feeling here. I mean, look. What's to escape from? I've escaped. I'm free, right? Yes. People are looking at me, probably think I'm an idiot. Who the hell's that guy waving his arms around? Honestly, I don't really give a shit at this moment. Probably the caffeine kicking in and my body is finally warming up. So therefore, my sense of humor is thawing out and my GAF is probably getting a little bit resilient as well. Well, I think it's time to start cleaning up. Not like there's much to clean up. Packing up is more like it. A couple more sips left. I think my lid is leaking. That sucks. All gone. So. Time to tear this down and get back on the road. My dog is waiting for me. My son's gone to a car show and then he's going out with a friend to like a college graduation kind of a thing. He invited him to tag along. So it's just me and the dog for a while when I get home. So it's gonna be peaceful. I'll probably do some reading, maybe meditate a little bit. Exciting times in my household. Meditation, yes. I already took him for a walk, so I don't need to do that. Although I'm sure he wouldn't complain if I asked him to go one more time. I am probably going to just go home and, like I said, read, warm up a bit. Because I'm still recovering from my night out at La Manche, so I didn't sleep much. Because that was I only got back from there yesterday. And out here today. So where am I going to go tomorrow? I have no idea. Go on my Google Maps when I get home after I'm done reading and I'll figure that out. So I'm all cleared up, packed up, and I'm ready. So I hope you enjoyed this ride today. Sorry we didn't get to go to that coffee shop out in Brigus. I was hoping for one in Cupids, but there was nothing there. And the Brigus one was closed down, and I just didn't have it in me to go looking around to try to find one that's open. But this was the perfect, alternative. This is what I wanted in the first place, was this. The coffee shop was the alternative. So I'm back to my original plan, boiling up outdoors. Anyway, I'll see you on the bike. I'm gonna say goodbye now because the bike is gonna be just a few little clips and we're done. So again, thank you for watching, and I hope you're finding something enjoyable out of this. At least the scenery. Probably not so much my talking, but the scenery should be good. So until the next video, take care of yourselves, and I hope you have an awesome May 24 weekend.
All right, we'll see you next time. It was beautiful. Thank you for the coffee. Thank you for this location. Yeah, I'm feeling grateful. All right, let's get out of this tricky spot. Again, reverse is awesome. And this is a very sketchy spot. Made it in one piece. Well, Google Maps is trying to tell me to go back to the Trans-Canada, but I'm kind of chilly right now, and I think I'm just going to stick to the slower road. Although it would be quicker to get home the other way. This road shouldn't be too bad today because I'm assuming most people are gone away for the weekend, so the traffic won't be as hectic.